I started out with a simple goal to experiment with Toyota Prius gearbox and inverter and get it to work as an electric drivetrain using open inverter board. Things took a thrilling turn when I came across a cheap Tesla motor on eBay. I could not resist the opportunity to take things up a notch. I decided to risk it, though it does look quite worrisome to go for this one. However, the offer is too good and I'm just gonna say I'm authorizing the payment. Okay, your order is in. Right, well, I feel quite relieved, but at the same time it just feels so scary. I could be wasting £700 on this. Anyway, we need to wait and see what's going to happen. Of course, after I placed an eBay order for the Tesla motor, I needed to get a version of the open inverter board that will work with the Tesla small drive unit. I had downloaded the design files from Damien GitHub and went to GLCPCB to get the board ordered. The design files were uploaded, but had come across a few component shortages. I was able to find PWM driver easily from Mauser, but as a power switch IC goes, I had to resort to going on AliExpress and ordering few of them from there. The good news, I already received an email notifying me that the shipment is coming. The bad news, I have to pay custom clearance and VAT, despite the fact that it's a second-hand item. And would you believe it, it did turn up. And here we go, this is the motor behind me. The package with the motor arrived a week earlier, but I did not have an opportunity to start working on it. But once I had a little bit of time, I started unpacking the package with excitement and worry mixed together. I was quite pleased with my initial observations, as there were no signs of any damaged parts. The only downside was clearly visible signs of the aluminium corrosion on some surfaces of the motor. And the great extra bonus, the high voltage cable was completely intact. My goal for this task is to remove Tesla inverter cover, but to gain access to the cover, I first will need to remove the cooling pipes and the black foam cover that isolates the inverter top. I also decided to remove high voltage cables to make my life easier later on. This little orange cup is covering the three-phase connection from the motor to the inverter. Until those three connections are done, it would be impossible to separate inverter from the motor. And of course, Tesla don't want you to go there. Since you peel off the label, you are presented with lots of warranty void messages on the label itself. I removed the screws securing the cables for the phase 1, 2 and 3 to the inverter. After all this, unbolting inverter was a very straightforward exercise. The only sticky part was unplugging a temperature sensor connector and encoder connector. With the inverter removed, I couldn't help but admire the incredible level of technology Tesla had even in 2013 when this car was built. Now I can focus on removing the top board from here. I need to remove the whole bottom plate and the board together because the bottom plate has current sensors embedded in the plate and they are soldered straight to the board. I found that the best way to get rid of protective lacquer would be to heat it up with the soldering iron and actually scrape it off while moving the soldering iron across those three contacts. Having removed the lacquer layer, I started to use lots of flux and sucking device to suck out all the solder from those connectors. Well, looks like I messed up really badly, guys. Unfortunately, I was trying to unsolder these sensors, the current sensors, and each of them has four pins, and I broke one pin of each sensor.
I had a good look at the sensor and I could not see any remnants of the lag remaining on body of the sensor, but I decided to remove it anyway. Unfortunately, the pin was broken right at the root of the casing.
Well, what a day. Where do we go from here? No idea.
In despair, I went searching on the Open Inverter forum and DIY Electric Car forum for replacement sensors. I also posted a question on the Open Inverter forum, but so far no one came back with any advice. And at this moment, help came from a completely unexpected source.
If only someone had done all this work years ago and posted it on the video and the forum. The SDU current sensors, I'm Alexis MLX91209CA. Exact the same as Model 3 drive units, usually in stock at Mauser.
I had a quick look on the Mauser website and yes indeed, they were available. The only one little niggle was that the right model was not there. but help came again from fellow EV conversion enthusiast.
I'm not sure if it helps, but I searched for 7.3 millivolt per millitor and found AS Electronics seems to have them in stock.
And yes, indeed, they were available, and I got them. Now, with renewed hope, I started to work on finishing the open inverter board, so it is ready when the sensors will have arrived. When I ordered the open inverter board for the Tesla small drive unit, a few components were missing. Those were PWM driver and FETs that drive the pre-charge and main contactor. I have started from PWM driver, as the smallest component it was fairly easy to solder. At this stage I decided to actually test the board to ensure that both supply voltages are present, as I did not want to do any more soldering and find out that part of the board is not working. I quickly hooked up 12 volt wires and connected to my power supply. So we are not consuming any current and power is zero. So this means that our voltage is not getting into our system. So what I need to do is to measure 12 volts on the input, and we are getting 1198, and we are getting only 0.6 volts on after the diode. This means that this diode is maybe not soldered incorrectly. So let's have a look and see whether we got the right polarity for this diode. I found that my board was assembled incorrectly, and cathode, the negative electrode, was connected to the 12 volt supply, and positive anode was connected to the capacitor. Obviously, I needed to reverse the polarity of this diode. I decided to check the second Schottky diode in a schematic that was connected to the output of the voltage regulator, and to my disappointment found the polarity of that one was also wrong. I unsoldered both diodes, cleaned the pads using solder wick, and now soldered them back in, this time using right polarity. Right, let's give it a try. Power supply is on. Enabling the power, and it's working. LED is on. Fantastic. At this point, I noticed that my 3.3 volt supply was drifting, while the 5 volt supply was very stable. Right, I think I found another mistake. The 3.3 volts is dropping is because this marked side of the tantalum capacitor should be plus, and it should be connected to pin 2 of the regulator here. It's 3.3 volt. Wow, I'm beginning to think that this Tesla build is cursed. But in this case, I'm enjoying solving these little problems and moving on to the next one. I removed the capacitor using the same method as I used for the diode and soldered back in reverse polarity connection. Now power supply is on, and now 3 volts, 3.28. And it seems quite stable. Another problem solved. I decided to program open Tesla inverter board before I start soldering any more components. As usual, I use ST-Link programmer to do the programming bit. First, I need to connect ST-Link programmer and load the bootloader. Program and verify. After this, I could program the signed firmware and program and verify again. Yes, that looks good. No surprises this time for me. Once I programmed the board and I could see that it was working, I could finish off by adding missing components. Soldering FETs is a bit more challenging. As they have rather large heat sinks, I had to cover the pad and FET backside with the flux and heat the pad for much longer to ensure that solder properly had flown into the pad. Now I have external connector on the board, I need a receptacle part so I can expose some connections for testing. This means that I have to assemble Molex connector and crimp some wires. Well, let's get crimping. Excellent, guys, our board is progressing nicely and it's almost ready for testing. I already have a connector and testing harness built up. Now I want to do a simple startup test just to start an inverter, power on, ignition on, press start button and see if the web interface shows us that the inverter is started. Okay, first I need to plug in the connector here. Oops. So we rearranged our power. Okay, now the crunch time. Power supply is on. And apply the power and the switch on, and it's working. As for the rest of this test, I had to reconnect to the ESP module to make sure that I have a connection to my VMOS D1 mini, and then start inverter in the manual mode and inverter started. Excellent, it's working. The task is to put the Tesla open inverter board, which will go in this position over here. I took the approach where I fitted sensors into the PCB first without actually soldering them in, and then I could load the PCB with the sensors into the base plate mounting position and fit the fixing screws. Okay, now we can assemble the board. Two of the high voltage cables will go through these. I finished the assembly of the board and I just needed to fit in the bracket directing the three-phase high voltage cable that's connected to the motor terminals. Installing inverter back was very simple affair. To finish off, all I needed to do is to attach the three screws that holding the phases that go from the inverter into the motor. I've decided just to carry on with the testing by using pipe inserts. So what I found, 10 mm pipe push fits can be actually fitted in this cable quite easily, and they actually really make perfect connection.
Okay, I'm using pipe inserts, great decision, but how do we gonna attach the cable? I think there is not enough space for crimping, so I've decided of course to try soldering. I quickly soldered in the connector cable for the high voltage plus and minus and isolated the part of the cable that was sticking out from the pipe.
I have my setup here, which some people may call Heath Robinson, but for the first test I think it's gonna be okay. So these connectors really work well. So they plug in into the high voltage cable and fit very nicely. So the rest of setup is here. So we have pre-charge contactor, main contactor, pre-charge resistor, and our famous Prius throttle pedal. This red and black wires would be our 12 volt supply, and this is the ignition switch, and this is our start button, and this little switch there, it's our direction switch.
Well, it's all good talking about 12 volts, but you may ask, where is the high voltage? How do we power the motor? For this test I'm using a contraption of four power supplies connected in series. And for the first test, I decided to connect in the bulb to work as a some sort of a protection limiting current device, as well as an indicator. The amount of glow will increase with proportion of current drawn by the inverter.
Right, so now we're gonna try the first run. I am a little bit nervous, I have to say, but hopefully our bulb will work as an indicator of how things are, and I expect it to light up at the first moment during the pre-charge cycle. So once pre-charge cycle is complete, I expect the bulb to turn off. You can see that the bulb is flushed. Yeah, pre-charge is closed and main contactor is open.
After I increased the current limit for my 12 volt power supply, if I pressed on the pedal, the bulb started to glow. This was an indication that we're actually drawing more current, but the motor was not rotating. But once the pedal was released, the current stopped flowing. So I've decided to run another experiment with the bulb removed.
Okay, I now removed the bulb, and effectively we have this connection instead of the bulb, and it goes straight into the main contactor. High voltage power supply is on. Now I'm switching the low voltage power supply. So now 12 volts is enabled. And we have rotation. Unbelievable. So this is our pedal. Press the pedal and you hopefully can see that motor is rotating. Put the motor in reverse and it's going in reverse. Okay, now it's stopped and I'm now going to go forward. And it's going forward. It feels rather smooth. Fantastic. Wow, the motor is working. What a relief. When I damaged the current sensors, I did not think I will ever get it to spin again. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Please give it thumbs up if you did. Please like and subscribe if you want to follow along. And I will see you on the next one.